I'm not tall enough to say you're child had gone to the same sperm donor. They said, you were C165 or whatever, red. And they're like, yeah, so now they spend Christmas together as a whole, you know, extended family. Meanwhile, the couple has broken up, but their children play together, you know, the brother and sister. So I just think that the way the families are span out so interestingly would be cool.
Gay married couples therapy is something that I like to say. You know, a great couples session.
Oh, what therapy?
Yeah, therapy, oh, therapy session.
You know, it's funny because in the piece I do remember when, and this is many years ago, when my mom had a young woman who came out to her as lesbian. And my mom thought this was wonderful, had no problem with it, although she did prefer to Sue's girlfriend as Sue's lady friends. And the only thing she was concerned about, and this is why gay marriage actually answers her question, was security. And she did wonder, she asked me, she said, to be a lesbian and still marry a rich man.
Were there any roles in this that we played that we felt we had a certain connection with, either on our own behalf or somebody else's behalf?
I certainly did in the monologue. I think the piece is very eloquent about generations of gay people who were not, you know, far less disenfranchised than even they are now. I grew up, you know, being raised by that generation of people, so I feel very motivated by that, you know, that paying tribute to that generation. I think sometimes nowadays I think it's short trip, unfortunately. It's nice to lose us, call them out in a really good way, give that credit where it's due. And yeah, because of my age, I'm very aware of that generation, and it means a lot to me.
I think the piece in general, the first time I ever did it was in Los Angeles, and it was at a benefit, and it was a one-night thing, and I was excited just by the performance. I thought that was the interesting thing. I didn't have an opportunity to read all the pieces and go, gee, wouldn't that be lovely if I got to do that one? And I knew that Paul had written something, and I hoped it would be mine, but I don't remember if that was something that was had been decided or offered that I was going to get to do that one. I just thought, for sure, this would be a great one to get to do. And then once I got to do that one, I was going to do that. But it really was that this is a great thing, the first really important wedding I ever went to. I've only been to a few weddings, and the first really important one was a gay wedding. And I really understood, at least, you know, the penny dropped for me about what marriage meant to people and why somebody would want to marry and why, after all these years, like in the piece that Richard was talking about, although these two people did feel differently, they felt like, we need this. We need families legitimized in a way. And it was actually really beautiful, simple, tiny, really meaningful wedding, and I thought, this is the wedding. This is, you know, hard one, and it really means so much to those, that couple, and to all of us that got to live in.
I went to one where they did, they danced to the theme from Dirty Dancing together.
Two friends of mine were married in L.A. are just cheating.
Congratulations on your boy, aren't you?
Thank you. The two guys who came to the show last night, who got married.
Yes.
They got married yesterday, and they came to see the show on their wedding night. Yeah, that's kind of depressing, isn't it?
Well, you said, and I taped it because we're going to put it online, you know, trying to sell the show, get awareness. And you actually asked, you hear it on the tape, he said, why didn't you go to Book of Mormon? You didn't take him to Book of Mormon. I'm going to get a Broadway show with you. My experience was it was the first one that I went to, and it was all about the families. Like any other wedding, it was it was that the mothers were, you know, kind of eyeballing each other. Already what happens at every other wedding I've been to had started to happen. For some reason, that was oddly comforting. Hey. Very uncomfortable.
Hey, I'm actually an ordained minister. I think that by the laws of New York, you and I might be married now.
I've been to gay weddings, but even more than that, I am addicted to reading gay wedding announcements in the Sunday Times because, and I've become so happy and so judgmental. There was one couple just fairly recently, two very handsome young guys, and one of them was like, they were both 22 and 23. And I thought that really is extraordinary, both that they can get married and that they are getting married. And then another part of me wanted to say, you're 22 and 23, what are you doing? but it's sort of wonderful because now you have this enormous variety of couples getting married. You know, and you see the couples who have clearly been together for 4 years, and you know what it means to them to be able to make that announcement and have that ceremony. And that just seems so precious, and there actually used to be a line in the announcement play that it's true that sometimes if I look very quickly through the straight wedding announcements, and if the straight couple is very young and have bold haircuts, I think they're lesbian.
Has anybody heard any? Has there been a divorce yet?
That I'm waiting for the first.
Yes, I don't know, but this is a good sign that it is true equality. Pointed out in another one of the plays that a number of the earliest gay marriages have now ended. But I think, no, we're not asking for gay protection. You know, the way the fact that gay marriage can withstand everything straight marriage can withstand is a good sign. But yeah, I wouldn't want to be that first couple to say, oh, sorry, yeah. No.